The heavenly twins return to Earth in triumph. Copters from the carrier Wasp pick up Major James McDivitt and Major Edward White after they splash down in the Atlantic 98 historic hours from their blast off at Cape Kennedy. In 4 days, they completed 62 orbits and traveled almost 1.75 million miles, 2.5 round trips to the moon. Major White's walk, of course, had the world agog. A little more than 2 months after the Russian stroll, the U.S. had closed the space gap. The two astronauts are ferried to the Wasp, where they are to undergo extensive medical checkups before returning to the mainland and the hero's welcome that is their due. Doctors who had monitored every breathing moment the men were aloft found both astronauts in fine physical shape. They had shattered many illusions about the adverse effects of exposure to the mysteries of outer space. Bearded, tired, hungry, mostly hungry, they both are the very picture of jauntiness as they acknowledge the cheers of the crew. Little about the flight went wrong. The re-entry computer went out of whack, but they brought the Gemini 4 down within 40 miles of the target area with the retro rockets. They attempted a near rendezvous with the booster rocket, but gave up the chase when they and Mission Control felt they were using up too much fuel. Otherwise, the saga of the Gemini 4 exceeded even the most optimistic expectations. And the world will long remember those moments when a hatch was opened and Major White stepped into the void. Gemini 4 speeds around the Earth at 17,500 miles an hour. Here is the historic moment as Major White removes his lifeline from the tether bag. The oxygen communications cable is slightly shorter than the 25-foot safety line that leashes him to the capsule. For theater showing, these pictures have been optically processed. Originally made at 6 frames a second to conserve film, they have been slowed to 24 frames a second to show every detail as White moves slowly and deliberately as he planned to do. Remember, there is no friction in space. A sudden move could send the Major tumbling. However, he uses his jet oxygen gun with impunity, moving with daring caution as he speeds across the United States. He was supposed to stay out only 10 minutes or so. He found the sensation so exhilarating that he strolled for 6,000 miles, 20 minutes alone in the cosmos with the Earth as his footstool. This, then, is the new horizon of mankind. Major White experiences none of the disorientation reported by the Russian cosmonaut. He floats to the end of his safety line, at no time losing his sense of direction, as this camera affixed to the capsule records. Now watch the lower right-hand corner of the screen. A spare mitten, loose in the weightless environment, drifts from the capsule out into space. It is probably still in orbit. Now the camera used by Major McDivitt from within the capsule. Major White comes floating by the window and fends himself off from the capsule with a gentle touch. It was here that McDivitt told the ground, "When Ed gets out there and starts whipping around, it sure makes this spacecraft hard to control." Of course, in this outer void, he could push the 7,000-pound capsule around with his forefinger. Major White experienced an exhilaration that he could not explain. He stayed out twice his allotted time, and his 20-minute stroll was 10 minutes longer than the Russian feat. Ground control began to get a little worried. They had to coax and then command White to return to Gemini 4.
The flight director says get back in.
This is Jim. What got a message for us?
Gemini 4, get back in.
Okay. I don't know. What's going on with the West there? They want you to come back in now. Back
in, come on. We took that 3.5 days ago, buddy.
Okay, don't worry about that. Come on in. Ed, come on in here.
Gemini 4, Houston,
Capcom. Okay, any other messages for us, Houston?
Yeah, get back in.
As White turned reluctantly to the capsule, he said, for all the world to hear, "It's the saddest moment of my life. It was the happiest for everyone else." To all the nations of the West, this was a triumph that belonged to all the free world, not to the U.S. alone. Back on the Wasp, with the first medical tests over, shaved, bathed, and fed, the Heavenly Twins took time to give the vehicle that carried them to glory a careful twice-over. The two men, rested after a 10-hour sleep, give the crew of the Wasp a short course in space flying. The Gemini 4 will be returned to the Space Center for a bolt-by-bolt, inch-by-inch examination in preparation for the next flight, that of Gemini 5 in the late summer. Neither man seems hesitant about re-entering the Gemini that was their home for 4 long days. Both expressed themselves as anxious to make another flight into the heavens. But whatever their future holds, nothing could surpass this unforgettable saga of White and McDivitt and Gemini 4.